org1. Let's get list of employees. So the transactional annotation, and that's pretty much it. Now let's run this. Okay, before that we need to start the Neo4j server so that we can save it. So I'm using the community edition. To the browser. So the default is Neo4j. Now I can give any password. So I'm giving 1 2 3 4 5 6 6. Now it's completely clean. Okay. Okay, so I have a problem in the controller, so it needs to be saved or any other. So these two were same, so it was giving error. Okay, now if I go to the save, now let's go to the Neo4j and database refresh. Go to the database. Now you see our node is created with organization and employee. So this is how you can do save. Now let's do other operation like update, read, and delete. Next up, let's do the read function. So everything I'm gonna do hard coded. You can get user input over here if you want. So maybe read. Date. So let's see. This is the organization which created ID with 0. So let's do read over here. Organization service. I can do read by name or read by ID. Read by name. This returns an organization. For read by name, we can do in the repo, we can add a method. Maybe we want to get a list of organization or a single organization. It doesn't matter. Just for the time being, let's do the list. That's it. Let's go to the org service. Okay, let's go to the controller. Let's read. We can do read by name, so organization org service dot read by ID. So our ID was 0, it should give me getting errors. So it's taking int. Read by ID. Oh, just add the L, that would do. And we can, you know, maybe print. Get name. Next up, we can get a list of all the organization with that name. List equal to, sorry, dot read by name. So what was the name in the database, which was org1, yeah, org1. So let's skip that name. Found void, okay. So this is going to send me a list. Okay. Now let's read on the project and see what happens. Okay, so project is ran. Now let's do the reading. So here we get the organization name, but we didn't get the size of it because it didn't return a list because we didn't print the size. So let's just print that. Now let's do the update. So you can pretty much do the same over here. So again, you can do it taking input from the user. I'm just doing it for now, hard coded. New name. Organization. Finally, let's do the delete. Update a delete. Let's go to the arc service and write the delete method. Update and delete method. Finally, the delete. You can simply just send the ID over here. You can also send organization, that is also valid. So yeah, that's it. Next, let's do the home controller. And for delete, update, so update is date, and to delete, same, just delete. Now let's redeploy. Deploy done. Now let's do update. Check out this. So here's the organization. Let's guess the new name. If I do delete, should delete this. Let's check it out. And we have nothing. No organization. I have only employee. So yeah, that's it guys. That's all I wanted to show you in this video. I hope you like it. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment below. The code will be in the GitHub. The link will be provided in the description as well. Okay, bye bye.